Hello and welcome to my creating room. We are jumping into an image today that's all about fire and compositing, as usual. Not usual fire, but compositing. So we're jumping in here and I'm so excited. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer. And essentially what that means is that I go out there and I make things and then I personally put them into Photoshop to finish them. I make things for myself and by myself, and then later on, I sell them through galleries or licensing for album art or book covers or things like that. So that's what I do. And let's take a look at this image. So here we've got a really, really fun image, and I'm particularly drawn to an image like this because it's more close up than I would normally do. Usually I have the camera pulled back further. So let's take a look at how this was created. First of all, we've got the location. I actually started with a location here, even though it's really hard to see in the final image. So I started with a location. It was a normal field filled with green grass, which I changed initially to be red. And then we'll see some changes going on. So I put this gray fog in, a super dark, creepy background, because I knew we were creating a super dark, creepy fire image, and so we wanted lots of smoke. And so we've got smoke in here as well, just popping in all over the background, trying to create an even composition. For example, we have one stream coming up here, and then I pop in. It's really challenging to get somebody to just pop into a space, as you know if you've ever tried this. It's not so easy as just saying, and then I put myself in the frame. No, it's never that easy. So what I did was I photographed myself on a backdrop where hopefully I would have some separation from the background. And so what I mean when I say separation from the background is that I really wanted to create maybe a good depth of field so that the background was blurry but I wasn't. That would really help for cutting hair off of the background. A backdrop where my hair contrasted with it so that maybe my hair is light and the background is dark. These things, having that separation in terms of the depth of field as well as the color and contrast and lightness and darkness, super important for cutting things off of a background. So when I use my layer mask here, which I did, I could get rid of some of the stuff around my subject, like the background, just cut that away with my normal layer mask. But then I could also use my background eraser tool, which is found under the regular eraser tool. You'll see background eraser. And when you click on the actual layer, not the layer mask, let me just make sure that we get a good size going here. And that's a bit small, so a little bit bigger. Tolerance is at 50. This brush is just going to allow me to come in and just start erasing hair. And it's trying to naturally separate it from the background. So if you're ever having an issue with hair, if you're like, gosh, this hair will just not go, it's just stuck to the background and I can't separate it, the problem is probably the way that you shot it. Think about if the background has enough contrast, enough separation. And then once you get it into Photoshop, go in with your background eraser tool and just start erasing along the edges of what you want to separate. This is a really good one for hair. So if you're ever in doubt, go to the background eraser tool and see if you can make it work. All right, so let's see. We've got our subject in, and this is the beginning of the fire. All right. So what I did was I took just some regular computer paper, I put it on a stool outside, and I lit it on fire. Yes, it got slightly out of control. Yes, it was fine. Don't worry. But do be safe if you do something like this. So I photographed the pieces of paper that were on fire from above and from straight on, just trying to get lots of different options. And then I blended them into my dress. And this was really good because they blended pretty naturally given that they were the same color, both very light. And so I did this over and over, just adding it in wherever I could to create these really interesting effects. So I started to put in smoke coming out of the little holes for a bit of realism, which I thought was really good fun, just adding those smoke layers. And so those were the bits of fire that I added. I didn't want to take it overboard. I didn't want this to be a gruesome picture. So I left it at that. The rest of it was just toning, choosing where I wanted there to be highlights and shadows, choosing the color scheme, which for me was very important here because the colors allowed this image to pop. You know, this is a fire-themed image, so I wanted the colors to reflect that. Lots of really deep saturated yellows and reds, and that helps to tell the story. Because it's all well and good if you can make it look like there's fire somewhere, but does it tell the story you're trying to tell? And if it does, great. And if not, how can you make it tell that story? How can the colors, the composition, all of these elements that we sometimes take for granted, how can we enhance them so that it tells the story you need to tell? That's where I'll leave it today. I hope this was helpful for you. If you do play with fire, don't tell anyone that I told you to do it. And have fun. Bye.